Hey, what's up guys, welcome back. You're watching ForuTech. Most of custom ROMs nowadays trying to release their Android 16 base build, or they're trying to add some of useful Android 16 features in their Android 15 builds. We already reviewed latest versions of most popular custom ROMs and their GSR builds. You can find them in the video description. The most popular custom ROM, Rising OS team, have followed the same way. They released their new Rising OS revived version 7.1 Selene with addition of some interesting Android 16 and new amazing features. This build is started to roll out for all official devices, while unofficial and old devices can also try this build by using its GSR ROM. I booted this Rising OS GSR build on my 9RT and Poco X2. So we are going to review all new features which resembles with the Android 16 features. We also reviewed all new amazing features and changes done by the team. So all Rising custom ROM and GSR users will get idea what's new is in this ROM as compared to its old version 7.0. So watch this video till the end. Now without further delay, let's get started. I successfully booted this custom GSR build on OnePlus 9RT and Poco X2. Everything is same for both of these devices, so I will only review this ROM on OnePlus 9RT. About device section of new Rising OS is updated with Rising OS version 7.1 and its code name is Selene. This is the Android 15 based Rising OS version 7.1 build. It has the same Rising OS mini rocket Easter egg. Security patches are of steel May 2025. Build date of this ROM is of 21st June 2025. Remember, these details may vary for custom ROMs, while GSR ROM, most of these details will remain same for all devices except their kernel version. Now we'll check out new changes and the features of Android 16 added by Rising OS team. In the personalization and under QS panel setting, we got this new QS panel refractor toggle. This will enable the expressive design 3 user interface for QS panel. This is the default view of QS panel, and this is the new user interface which resembles with the Google's new expressive design user interface. After enabling the QS panel refractor toggle, only brightness slider looks old, but other tiles and their arrangement is somewhat similar to Android 16 QS panel user interface. Their on and off animations looks exactly similar like Android 16 animations. Editing page of tiles have same user interface and animations, while addition and removal of tiles. User interface of notification also looks similar to Android 16 with new rounded material you colored icons of respective application. It has new manage and clear all shortcuts at the bottom of notification panel. But remember, when we keep enabled the QS panel refractor toggle, none of other customizations of QS panel and notifications will work until we disable that toggle. QS style widget toggle is available in this setting, but in this new build we got these new widgets for QS panel. This single widget tile have 4 different panels with different widgets. First one have now playing media. On the second page it have Wi-Fi and Bluetooth control. On the third page, it have Rising OS personalization setting shortcut. It also have Google Gemini shortcut key. Next, it have settings panel key shortcut. On fourth, it have shortcuts to open running services option of your device. On the last section of this widget, we get the torch, calculator, camera application and alarm application shortcuts. This is a comprehensive widget with 4 sections with lots of different useful shortcuts, but for now it's not customizable. If it gets customization, we can convert it into any useful assets for your smartphone. Next, under the themes and setting UI, we get this new toggle called as expressive design. This will enable some expressive design look for your settings panel. like settings panel options, will get new card like user interface with new big rounded icons. Even on and off toggle settings of different options gets this new X and tick mark like user interface, which resembles with new Android 16 design. Next is the unexpected addition of Android 16 feature of cinematic effect for wallpapers. When you apply any downloaded third-party wallpapers, you get this option at the bottom. First, it will download the data for this feature. Once done, it will process the wallpaper and give slight 3D animation and motion effect. This feature is not much advanced like Android 16 feature, but still it gives slight animations for most of wallpapers, which looks cool. Along with this, you get this new Nothing Phone One like dot matrix unlock animation. That one also looks very good. Next, in the battery setting, you get Android 16 new battery information option, which provide details of your battery health, like its design and maximum capacity with health. If your device design capacity is same like maximum capacity, then your battery health is good. But if it's too low, it may show your device battery health as a bad, which needs to be replaced. So these are some Android 16 features added by RisingOS team. Instead of this, we also got new features like in the theme section, we already have old power menu styles. But now in the toolbox and under the extras option, we get new power menu styles like light Android 12, full Android 11, classic Android 8, grid and legacy Android 7 styles of power menu. These are power menu styles of old Android versions, as I mentioned along with its name. I especially like this classic A8 style of power menu. Next, for recent application shortcut menu, team added new uninstall shortcut for user application installed. So you can directly uninstall respective application anytime by using this shortcut option. These are all new Android 16 features and other new changes I found for this amazing operating system. If you are using GSI build, you may face some bugs that I shown in the review of old RisingOS 7.0. You can check it from the iCard video. RisingOS custom ROM users will not face any kind of those issues. With this new update, RisingOS team tried to avoid any kind of initial Android 16 builds. They added some Android 16 features right into their Android 15 build and given a big surprise for their users before release of stable RisingOS Android 16 build. This is all about for today, guys. Hope you liked our work. Then please do like and share this video. Subscribe to our channel. Press the bell icon for notifications of our upcoming in-depth review of all custom ROMs and their GSI builds. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Take care. Bye-bye.